Ahoy, let me show you something. So I've got here this cheap no-name macro lens for a smartphone. Then I have here Canon M6 Mark II with a Viltrox speed booster macro extension and 50mm lens. I also have here adapter. I can use it instead of the Viltrox speed booster, but the Viltrox speed booster gets me even closer. And lastly, I have here another smartphone macro lens by Moment. Now, Moment sent it to me to test it out, to have fun with it, and I've been obsessed. I've been obsessed with this. I've been shooting, I've been comparing it to the other stuff I have here, the quality and all that. I even went that far that I submitted all the photos to stock. Can this thing actually make you money when you combine it with a smartphone? If you are new here, welcome. My name is Zdenka Darla. If you're all about photography and video, consider subscribing to this channel. I created macro photography tutorial on this channel a long time ago. I actually think that it was even a camera challenge, and I did that all with the Canon M6 Mark II with the adapter and macro extension kit and 50mm lens. I think I used the Viltrox speed booster as well. And those photos were absolutely beautiful. High quality, because this camera with that type of setup can really produce really high quality images. And I submitted it to stock. All photos were accepted, no problem. And they are doing quite well. They are selling. Now, I actually use this combination of macro extension kit with 50mm lens with Canon 5D Mark III when I used to photograph weddings. All the jewelry shots and all the ring shots. About 2 years ago, I bought this very cheap set on Amazon. It's a whole bunch of filters and this macro lens for a smartphone. And I bought it just more out of curiosity. To be honest, coming from such a high quality cameras and lenses and used to seeing certain quality of images, I was a bit disappointed with this macro lens and I was disappointed with the filters. I thought, oh well, it's just a smartphone. But that was 2 years ago. That said, those filters and that lens is literally sitting in my storage collecting desk. I don't use it at all. I think I used it maximum 3 times. It was fun to try it out though. A couple of years later, which is now, Moment asked me if I would be interested to try something out, and I already bought from them anamorphic lens and telephoto lens, and I love them. So I selected to try the macro lens. Well, because it is recommended, and also I can see that it is one of the best selling lenses on their website. I was so skeptical, but I was very excited to try it out. I spent the whole weekend chasing bugs around the house, literally, and just taking a whole bunch of test photos, just see what it can do, what quality I'm gonna get out of this. I was actually quite impressed the way the photos look on the smartphone screen. It's actually pretty easy to use. The way you use it, just mount it over the Moment case on your smartphone, and you can mount it over the standard lens or telephoto lens. When you use standard, you will see a little bit more obviously, and if you mount it over telephoto lens, you will get even bigger magnification. You can see even more, you get more macro shot. Now you can use it in any app, but I optioned to use it with the Moment app because I could shoot manually, and I can also shoot raw. That means that I can preserve our data. It's not going to be a JPEG file, but raw, and then I can edit it in a post in Photoshop and Lightroom, and I'm gonna stay with a very high quality. The only thing I didn't like as much, because it is 28mm, you have to be so close to the object. So if you are taking photo of a bee or fly, you have to be literally right here. It's very difficult to take photos of them with this type of a setup. Now, this part can be removable. I never removed it though, because it will give you better light. And also it's gonna be way easier to know when you are close enough. You just have to literally touch it, touch the object with it to be that close. Now, when you take photos with Canon M6 Mark II and this type of a setup, you don't need to go as close at all. You can shoot it quite from a distance. There's also one big major difference between taking photos with a mirrorless camera, macro shots, and smartphone camera. I'm not talking now about the macro lens. I'm talking about the actual smartphone in general. When I'm taking photos with Canon, I can adjust how much focus I want in the photo. I can bring the aperture way up if I want to see a lot of these items sharp, or bring it way down if I want only a little part of the item to be sharp. When you take macro photos with your smartphone, you don't have that. There is a fixed aperture. When you are looking at the Moment app, you can control shutter speed, ISO, exposure compensation, but no aperture. Still though, I have to admit that I was very impressed whatever was popping up on the screen on the smartphone. The photos looked really good. But still though, I was still pretty skeptical. So I took the shots, uploaded it on a computer, looked at it at 100%, and I started playing with it with the Photoshop and Lightroom. And I can tell you that I knew that smartphones have smaller sensors, of course, and I was expecting a bit different quality. Certainly not the same as what you get from a cameras like that, like the Canon cameras. The images are not going to be as clear, it's just different once you view it at 100%. I did some editing, I had to fix few things, like minor problems, like here and there was a little bit of a grain in a shot. And I submitted all the photos to stock agency. I wanted to see if smartphone macro shots will pass the bar, if I can actually make money with it. Now the photos I submitted, they're not gonna sell. No, they're not gonna sell. I submitted just the test shots, taking bugs and flowers and stuff, random stuff around the house. They don't have a commercial value, they are not gonna sell. If I really wanted to sell photos, if I really wanted to upload photos which sell, I would probably take photos of, let's say, little tiny letters where I would write a word like a help or different things. Basically, photos which have high commercial value, which I know for sure they're gonna be for sale. Now, all I wanted to do with this test to see if it can pass the bar, if the images will technically be accepted by stock agencies. I haven't submitted smartphone photos before yet, and I can tell you that I wasn't sure because I'm used to the clear photos from a big cameras, and I know what type of stuff they want and how very specific and clear the images must be. I waited for a week or two and the results are in. Now, usually when I submit to stock agencies, I do have generally 100% acceptance rate with those cameras, and I've done it for years, so I know exactly what they want to see and what they don't want to see when it comes to technical part. All outdoor photos with natural light were accepted. Bingo. All tests I did in a studio were not accepted. Too much noise, they didn't like the focus much. Simply only a little part was in focus because the aperture is so low. I also think they didn't like this set much, as honestly, they didn't think it's gonna sell for them. Bottom line though, combination of a good smartphone with this macro lens, which is high quality, I gotta admit, can potentially make you money. The photos are available on stock, they're available to be purchased. Now, besides the photos, you can also do video with this. Moment has this pack of adapters which allow you to mount a VND filter on all their lenses. Just look at that. This is a VND filter on top of the macro lens. It's mind-blowing how this whole smartphone photography video world has advanced. It's quite interesting. All right, all the items I was showing in today's video, including the Canon M6 Mark II and the setup there, I linked below the video in a video description in case you want to check that out. Well, hit the thumbs up if you found this video interesting, because the whole thing to me was quite interesting. Subscribe to future videos like these, and if you have any questions, comments, simply want to say hi or ahoy, you know what to do. Leave it below. And I'll see you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao. Ahoy.